questions and DMs pretty much every day from folks asking particularly about supplies, but paint in particular, because a lot of you are considering doing the Insider Studio. You want to know what I recommend. Some of you are just, you got extra time on your hands, so you're taking up paint as a hobby, which is wonderful. Some of you are homeschooling now and find yourself in need of art supplies that you never needed before. Well, we're gonna go. Get down on it. I wish you could smell this. I was worried I wouldn't get the good smell through my mask, but you know what? The smell is still good. September at Michael's. It's like May for gardeners. For me, it's like this is peak season. Everything is so, look at all the fall goodness. This is my happy place. But also, you see all these like pockets that are like kind of empty and stuff? That's because they're making room for holiday and Christmas, which means bargains are aplenty. Okay, when you come to Michael's and you think paint, I think a lot of people think about this aisle. It's the little bottles of the craft paint. And if you have a bunch of these already, I'm not going to tell you to buy all new stuff, but I will tell you that this is, in this bottle, more than 50% water. The pigment load is very, very poor. It's not ideal. It's not great, I mean, in comparison to the alternatives. However, at 89 cents, you can, for $5, you can essentially get yourself going and painting. I'm gonna show you something different, but again, this is not ideal. If you already have this, I will show you some gesso that you can use to bulk this up to increase the opacity. One of the things I really don't like about it though is, you see how it's starting to kind of separate and stuff already? This is going to be a certain like gloopiness consistency. I can't even shake it. It's solid. Whereas there's probably another one on here that's totally, yeah, this one's totally liquid. They don't, to blend them together, you almost need like a Cuisinart. It's not fun. It's not ideal. Exception in the craft aisle is the Martha Stewart line multi-surface paint. These are indoor, outdoor use. They're essentially waterproof. Whatever they chemically added to these to make them waterproof, the longevity factor is fantastic. I have found them to be pretty light fast, and they're really great. They're $2.50, which is a significant uptick from the 89 cents, but a lot of you are more comfortable having lots of small bottles as opposed to actual artist paint. This is great. This is why I use this in the secret garden to demo. But if you were feeling like building a collection of paint, I would actually head over that way to the art aisle and let's talk about something else. Usually they keep it at a very distant other corner of the store. I don't know if it's to intimidate people or what. The art paint aisle, and in every store, doesn't matter if it's Michael's or whatever, there's usually an A grade and a B grade aisle. The paint manufacturers like them to be divided that way. The golden people don't want to be featured side by side with Artist Loft. That's a purposeful distinction, not just price. If I was to do a tour, I would say this is art paint, but it's maybe student grade or academic grade. This is middle grade. This is, if you feel like you know what you're painting, but you want to invest a little bit more, Liquitex Basics is a terrific place to go. Academy, I'm okay with. I haven't used it enough, so I'm going to say it's better or worse. Winsor Newton is classic. It almost intimidates me. I barely ever use it. Liquitex Professional Grade is good. I find it to be pasty, but that's a personal preference. If I'm going to spend the money for this, I'd rather get golden. Golden is sort of my, if I'm going to spend the money, if I'm selling the work, golden is where I want to be. But it's very expensive. Reasons why I actually like shopping Michael's for golden as often as I can, more than art stores, because they're obvious with the prices. When you go to art stores, they don't tell you the cost of this is a lot less than the cost of this. We just sort of assume that all paint bottles cost the same, but pigments, they're very different in terms of manufacturing. So the ones that cost more to make cost more to the consumer as well. I love that I can see that this is $7 and this is close to $11. I always expect reds, so look at this. Red paint is notoriously unstable. So this is interesting. So the cadmium red, which is a classic, this is a good solid red. That's at the $8 range. At the $11 range, we have the pyrrole red. I'm going to guess, although I'm not an authority, I'm not going to guess side by side, this is more opaque. If you find a lesser expensive red paint, the more transparent it's going to be. And this is another thing to consider. With these paints, they're very, very often, purposefully transparent, but they just are transparent. They're not intended to be used straight out of the bottle. This is intended to be mixed down with either a medium, which are going to be, oh, usually they're here. No, where are the mediums? Them. They used to always feature under the specific brand. Now they're in one section. More often than not, painters will mix their best pigmented paints with matte gel, gloss gel. I was talking about modeling paste the other day. This is good stuff. For mediums, I tend to go Liquitex. I don't notice the difference between Liquitex and Golden, and Liquitex is usually a friendlier price. Speaking of price, though, the prices of the paint, it's very confusing. Pretend this is the grocery store. The grocery store, you know when you get milk and it tells you what it is per ounce, not just the bottle? You're going to have to do your own homework here, but here you have to do it. So this was 89 cents and it's 2 ounces. So that's roughly 45 cents an ounce. Over here, Artist Loft, it's over 4 ounces at $4.49. That means this is about $1.10 an ounce. That means that this is over twice the amount of money for this. Is this twice the quality? No, not by a long shot. If you were to go over here, this is about $5.50 for 4 ounces. They're all $5.50. So that's about $1.30 an ounce. The difference between this and this for 20 cents, yeah, I would just not. No offense to Artist Loft, but if you're going to spend the money for the upgrade, just go directly to Liquitex Basics. Is this twice the quality of this? You're coming close. Golden, it's hard to calculate per ounce because each one is different. But I would say it's about $5 an ounce, okay? Is this five times the quality of this? Across the board, no, honestly, no, which is why I use this or comparable brands very, very frequently. But there are some colors that when they're diluted in all the filler, you just can't get. So there are definitely colors that I almost always buy, and I just go directly to Golden. Quinacridone Magenta is one of them. This is my love language. Payne's Gray is another one. There's just certain things you want to upgrade. Start with the small bottle, and then if you're doing the work, it's worth the investment, you're selling the stuff, yeah, maybe you want to go. But I see sometimes painters with these giant jars, and I don't know that they've done the math. Maybe they are. Bottom line, if you're thinking you need to, I hear people say things like you're only as good as the quality of the materials, and with paint in today's market, I just don't think that's true. I think that's a crutch for a lack of dedication. A good painter can make anything work. I am a snob about, and I've tried to replace it. Liquitex Professional Gesso. Not just any, this is a brand. Screenshot this. You can mix this with cheap craft paint, and suddenly this becomes award-winning quality paint. This stuff is just magic. It is expensive, though. It's full retail, $38. For this size, you can buy smaller sizes. This is what I save my coupons for. This is what I pretty much always buy 50% off, and I wait for it, but it's good. Something else that I really didn't know about these in a big way. It's acrylic ink. It's not watercolor ink. It's acrylic ink. I'm starting to really like these. They're mostly good for paper, but sometimes the like this is a fluorescent. I'll add a squirt of this to my regular acrylic pink or something, and it really makes it kind of oof. It juices it up in a really cool way. But there's a number. I want to experiment more with these. This is cool stuff. Of Sumi brushes. These are Sumi brushes. They're initially intended for Chinese calligraphy. It's a bamboo stem. I love them. You get really expressive strokes. But people ask me about like what brushes should I buy. Brushes are super personal, and I'm really cruel on my brushes, so I never buy the really, really good stuff. that's more of a reflection of my laziness than anything else. I tend to favor the floppy ones, but if you have a really delicate hand, you might want something that's firmer. So no advice here on this. These are my favorite canvases in the world. These are the best. They're the level 3. They're expensive. I pretty much only buy them on sale. A couple times a year, sometimes more, they have like a 70% off sale and I stock up. But you see how the backing, I love how that has a riveted backing. And the fabric quality, it's thick. There's not a lot of bounce. Let me show you. The level 1, which is still, it's a decent quality canvas, but okay, so the backing, exposed staples doesn't make or break a canvas. What does though? Do you see how easy it is for me to press that? That's not good. You don't want that. You want to just barely see a touch of a movement. That's way too much. I lied about brushes. I want to show you this one. This particular line is meant for oil, but I buy them. Do you see how long that handle is? Long handles. When you force yourself to hold them by the end, you're going to be a looser, more expressive painter. This will make you. You're starting out, don't buy canvas though, buy paper. This is what I buy most often than anything. 9x12 watercolor paper, or I get the 11x15 watercolor paper, and I trim off an inch because 11x14 is the standard size, and you don't want to have that extra thing and have to custom frame later on. But I want to ignore it because assuming you come here for full price stuff. So it's $17 for 30 sheets. It's to the tune of about 50 cents a sheet. That's pretty good for this size paper. I think that's a good deal. It's cold press. I don't care. I'm not picky about my paper so long as it can absorb water in a good way. Watercolor artists will get really picky. They want the hot press. They want the tooth. They want it sealed at the edges. I'm not there. I love watercolor and I love mixed media too. If I'm buying art supplies for kids or just young people in general, this in particular, the spiral bound 11x14, remember that's a regular size. So if you get something good out of it, it's ready to go. The spiral bound is nice for kids because you can literally just let them have a journal and they can fill it in however which way they want. If they're at the scribbling stage, that's great. If they want to do full out and collage, if something's good, it has perforation. So you can take it out and it's ready to go. But this is relatively thin paper, so it's also nice if you get something in here that you want to collage with later. This is a winner. How I was saying, 11x14 is a standard size. 11x14, but the outside frame is 16x20. This is probably my favorite. Do you see this? Double matte. I don't care what it is. If it's a doodle by your 3-year-old, you put it in a double matte, double white, in a white frame, it's going to look like it belongs in a museum. This is a great frame. And it comes in various... They have an 8x10 that goes in a square. It's very chic. Regular retail is $42. So it comes in other colors. It's a beautiful gray. There's a gold. There's a silver. The silver's new. I had not seen that one. It's a whole line. And I love this line. You always want to use a mat with acrylic work because you want an air pocket between the piece and the glass so it doesn't eventually stick to the glass and then it's not a great situation. That one is about $40. Honestly, these are they're not on sale today. I would say Michael's has this line on sale for 50% off, probably 50% of the time. So I would wait out a sale. But this is, even at full price at $40, to take an 11x15, which is non-standard, to take that to the framing section and have them put together, you'd be paying easily double, more likely 3 or 4 times more. So it's still a bargain. I pretty much clear out Michael's every time I go in because they only put out a few at a time. It's the wooden postcards. They're 99 cents. If you've watched my angel tutorial, I do ornaments on these. I stock up all year round so I can get them at Christmas time. Here's the thing. Oh, they don't have them. Well, I bet you they don't like you doing this, but I do it anyway. Pull out some drawers. All you see, they store inventory down here. There'll be more down here. I'll clear them out. Over in the chalk paint and stenciling aisle. Sometimes people ask me about chalk paint. It's made for furniture, but they ask me if they can use it in painting. Listen, I don't know enough about it, so I don't want to rag on it, but I will tell you, if it separates in the jar, it's probably not super stable. That is as much as I can tell you. So I don't use this, but I don't know what to tell you. If you already own some and you want to try using it, I'm not going to stop you, but that's not a great sign. For art supplies. Now let's get to the fun stuff. Look at this. Iron-on letters. Like, iron-on letters have been around since, I don't know, forever. But now it's actual glitter. It's actual freaking glitter. They come in tie-dye. Oh my, embroidery? Look, oh. Created their canvas bag situation to just, they always had like the kind of cheaper version. These are like actual substantive bags. I never saw these before. I'm wondering if I can tie-dye and actually paint on this. And then they have, this is my absolute favorite aisle. I never get out of here empty-handed. It's the sparkle section. It's just amazing. It's just, I can't, in the insider studio we do disco chickens and sparkle cats, and I just, it's not, I can do my life without glitter, but like, these are essentially confetti, or they're sequins without holes. This is my favorite thing. This is my peak love language. This piece. Ugh. Let's start here. You can get a giant bag of sequins. Full price, $16. You know I'm using a coupon. But just the endless... If you have a little girl in your life, and she doesn't have a bag, like a big peanut butter jar full of loose rhinestones, you're not letting her live her best life. So you need to get on that. And then this. Okay, so sequins are always fabulous. Sequins. Everybody knows this bag of sequins. What Michael's done is really smart. Look at these. They bake the glitter in it. So good. And then these. Look. They're not metallic. They're just hot pink. Or this. It's like Gem in the Holograms raspberry or fluorescent yellow. You didn't know you needed fluorescent yellow sequins. Now you're informed. I just found, you guys don't, I don't have pierced ears, so I essentially have to either make or alter my own. And I love these arc things, but I don't have any yet, so I'm gonna get me. Oh, look over here. Disappointing. So in the Insider Studio, we did a wreath situation, and I had suggested people get the loose grapevine wreath. This is marked at $28. This is $5. What? Wanted to do the tutorial and you're like, no, I'm not spending $30 to make a base. Just buy this and put some little twigs in it. That's all you need. Just skip that. Sorry, friends. Didn't mean to steer you wrong. $28. Jeez, oh, Pete. Here's a good one. I don't know if it's a bargain or not, but I think it's great. This is perfect size. It's tabletop or on the floor. If you generate a lot of flat storage or you're just trying to organize a lot of flat stuff, again, homeschooler friends, $30 on sale right now. I think that's a pretty good price. And this is a sturdy make. I will sometimes do these out of like pizza boxes and cardboard, but they don't hold heavy stuff. This looks pretty well made. It's kind of nifty. I like this thing where they're doing the multi-level wood. That would keep me very busy and very happy when I was young. This is cool. Ooh, Google Eye. My word, look at this sequin ribbon. See, I can't buy this though, because I'll never use it, because I'll think I'm saving it for a special occasion. And no one is special enough.